Imagine putting on the radio and seeing a splash of colors, or writing an essay based solely on how letters taste to you. It's a bit difficult to fathom, but that's exactly what makes it exciting. Hi, I'm Nishka, and today on Creatures of the Night, I'm going to be talking about a neural condition that's fascinated me for ages, and that is synesthesia. Synesthesia literally means senses coming together. To put it simply, when a certain stimulus activates a sense, an unrelated sense gets activated concurrently, causing you to hear colors or see sounds. When I had first heard of this disease, I thought to myself, wait, how do I get that? Unfortunately, synesthesia is an idiopathic disease, which means that a person who has had these experiences has had them for as long as they can remember, and it's usually caused due to a genetic mutation. But non-idiopathic versions of synesthesia do exist, with acquired synesthesia is usually caused due to brain injury or extensive drug use. There are many different types of synesthetes. The most common of these are color-graphemic or color-auditory synesthetes. Color-graphemic synesthetes are those that associate certain shapes, letters, and numbers with colors or patterns. The neural wiring of their visual cortex is a lot denser than normal. An example of a color-graphemic synesthete is Pythagoras. Another good example is Vladimir Nabokov, who is the author of Lolita. To watch an interview with a color-graphemic synesthete, check out the link in the description. Color-auditory synesthesia is the next most common. These are the ones that see different colors for different sounds. Many world famous musicians are synesthetic this way, such as Lady Gaga, which is pretty evident in her style, Pharrell Williams, and many composers such as Mozart and Beethoven. Another famous color auditory synesthetic is Melissa McCracken. She paints the splash of color she sees when she hears certain songs, and these are compiled on her website, which I've linked in the description. If you want a more in-depth experience of color auditory synesthesia, you can check out the 360 virtual reality video I've linked in the description. Another type of synesthesia can include lexical gustatory synesthesia, where certain words are associated with certain tastes or smells. Another interesting type of synesthesia is ordinal linguistic personification, where one tends to assign personalities to numbers, colors, shapes, or even objects. There are lots of theories as to what causes synesthesia. One of these suggests that we're all born synesthetes with connections between the different sensory areas in our brains, but as we mature, these connections are blocked. For synesthetes, this process doesn't take place fully, thus resulting in their synesthesia. Some others believe that synesthesia occurs due to decreased blood flow in the neocortex, or the part of the brain that handles sight and hearing. This is also the most recently evolved part of the animal brain. This leads me to wonder, maybe synesthesia is just part of evolution, and maybe one day we'll all be synesthetes. Alright, we hope you found this video interesting. If you want to check out some more cool content, you can click here. Or if you want to subscribe, you can click subscribe. We'll see you in the next video. Until then, good night, sleep tight, and don't let the C-mix reflect hilarious. Bye.